You cry, baby.
Trying not to cry.
It's a Beyond Strong Master Lee.
And Lulu.
All right, I wanted to continue on our journey exploring NF's history with his music, but we got to do a little bit of an interruption here because his new album has dropped.
Ooh.
Like, it's everywhere. People are listening to it. They say it's great. And I figure, well, we got to check out one of the songs from this. And Happy was one where they have a music video with it, and they dropped that too. No, an NF. And also, just looking at the thumbnail, it's not that happy looking. I think it might be an inside joke or something else because there's a bit of a darkness to it. It doesn't look like it's him this time. It's a picture of a girl.
Yeah, and at the end, it's happy.
Could be. It could be. You know, I think unlike a number of different people that, you know, tell stories about the troubled childhood, he is self-aware enough of, like, what it takes to become happy. Of like, look, I got to fight this. It's an eternal fight, but my future is defined by me going forward, and that's where my happiness is, all right? I like that message about him. He's very positive about it in the end, and he's really honest about, like, who he is and recognizing follow your dreams, follow your heart, be true to yourself. That's where the happiness is. So let's find out what it's all about and see if it's really happy.
Please.
By the way, if you want to hear some wild stories, well, you got to check out my Vegas show.
And if you want some hotness, check out my fantasy show. Happy ending.
And away we go.
Dear God, please hear me out. I know it's been a couple years since I've reached out and said hello. I bet you're wondering why I keep obsessing on and stressing all the little things when I should be living life and soaking up the memories. I know I've been selfish. I have no excuse.
It's like singing. I haven't heard him sing before.
Hanging by a thread's how I live. I don't know why, but I feel more comfortable living in my agony, watching my self-esteem go up in flames, acting like I don't care what anyone else thinks, when I know truthfully that that's the furthest thing from how I feel. But
that's like art fiction.
The truth is I need help, but I just can't imagine who I'd be if I was happy. Yeah, been this way so long, it feels like something's off when I'm not depressed. I got some issues that I won't address. I got some baggage I ain't open yet. I got some demons I should put to rest. I got some traumas that I can't forget. I got some phone calls I've been avoiding. Some family members I don't really connect with. Some things I said I wish I would've not let slip. Some hurtful words that never should've left my lips. Some bridges burn, I'm not ready to rebuild yet. Some insecurities I haven't dealt with yet. I'll be the first to admit that I'm a lonely soul, and the last to admit I need a hand to hold. Losing hope, headed down a dangerous road. Strange, I know, but I feel most at home when I'm living in my agony, watching my self-esteem go up in flames, acting like I don't care what anyone else thinks, when I know truthfully that that's the furthest thing from how I feel. But I'm too proud to open up and ask you to pick me up and pull me out this hole I'm trapped in. The truth is I need help, but I just can't imagine who I'd be if I was happy. Don't know what's around the bend.
She's so sad.
Don't know what my future is, but I can't keep on living in. Living in my agony, watching my self-esteem go up in flames, acting like I don't care what anyone else thinks, when I know truthfully that that's the furthest thing from how I feel. girl, but I'm too proud to open up and ask her to pick me up and pull me out this hole I'm trapped in. The truth is I need help, but I just can't imagine who I'd be if I was happy. I was happy.
Aww. You're right, baby. It was happy ending. Although, still very sad.
It is still sad.
Are you crying, baby?
Trying not to cry.
There's a lot to unpack here. Wow. One is, he sings. He's a really good singer, actually. Mm-hmm. Very little rapping. I mean, there's sort of like that, you know, sort of like storytelling he's in, but not like anything we've heard from him before. I don't know if you've ever seen him before, but like this is the first time we've heard him, and we're kind of new to his world.
Well, you can hear he's singing, but there's more of the rapping, right? But this one is
definitely very melodic. Probably the most melodic song we've heard. In fact, it's almost like radio catchy. Like there's a good beat to this song. It's really beautiful. Right. Like the song itself is actually really beautiful. But the story, though, it's an interesting what happened in the end, because up until that point, it's painting this picture of this child who clearly is living a neglected life and whose mother is neglecting her. And that child grows up to become like
just
that
like
mother.
Her.
Yeah, right? And so it goes so far to explain, like we talk about this a lot, actually. Mm-hmm. And this is a like core of like a lot, I think, what people deal with in life. This is not just stuff for everyone,
yeah, this
right?
is very common, right?
This is such a common theme about, and there's a quote for this, right? Like, you could take a girl out of a small town, and you can't take a small town out of a girl, right? Meaning that what you grow up with becomes your baggage.
Who you are.
It becomes who you are, and it's really hard to let go of that, no matter how far you try to run away from that. And it just seemed like that was that kind of story, like cautionary tale.
Yeah.
But the twist, that twist was, but you still have
you
choice.
Have the power
you
to
still have the power
change everything.
And the reason why you have the power, right? It's not because like you got everything you actually look back on is sad. It's more like what you choose to remember could be pure sadness, or it could also be the things that you remember that were happy. Mm-hmm. No one's life is that bad, right? And she's remembering, you know, there were happy times, and I choose to double down on that. I choose to follow through on that. And that, I think, is really the happy ending here that we're talking about, that we can actually move on from the sadness if we choose to remember the good things in life.
Yeah. It's a trial. It's not easy, right? Because
it's not easy. It's a constant battle. Because
it's a battle within yourself that no like one else understands, that no one else like, going to believe you.
You're stuck with that thinking in many ways. It's like habit. Like the bad thoughts can become habit. Your instincts can become habit. And if you don't train yourself to think about the things that were pleasant and then double down on that, you become a victim of potentially repeating the same bad mistakes that you have in life. Wow, what a story. Like, the dude's an amazing storyteller. Mm. Really quite phenomenal, actually. It was so cohesive. Like, you have to think about this, all right? He's singing, so you're listening to his words, but it's not actually what I would say, like it's happened exactly scene by scene. But the story is told in a way where it's so clear from beginning to end of what it's about. Mm-hmm. Like usually when we're here debating, you're going, well, this is how I interpret it. And I'm like, well, I think it means this. And then it usually be summarized with, all right, fans, what do you think this means?
Right, right.
I feel like this was pretty clear.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's hard to react, especially with me, because I'm so emotional. Like,
you can be emotional.
I don't
baby.
Want that's, to be.
Maybe if you want to be, that's the way. That's what reaction's for. It's an honest take of, like, you know, if you want to sob and ugly cry and boogers drip down your nose, that's fine. If it hurts you because, like, that's my child, like, let it out. This is our therapy. It's cheaper than therapy, I can tell you that. Just let it out.
Cheaper than therapy. There's going to be a lot of people.
Much cheaper than therapy.